phone the office about the script supervisor?
Not yet.
Okay. Let's just start where we finished. The hiding scene. He's just got out of his house and he's hiding in a bush outside the mansion where his wife's being held hostage. That's where we got up to.
Why has she been kidnapped again?
Because he tried to scam some guy out of buying a car.
And he didn't realise it was his brother's gang friend. So, are we supposed to be on his side?
Yes.
Well, I was thinking, cause obviously he did scam the guy, so he did sort of start it.
Yeah, but that's not quite as bad as kidnapping, is it?
I mean, I don't think that...
Would you side with the robbers?
No, I mean, we just shouldn't make it out like he's the hero. We should make it neutral.
That's boring. The audience needs someone to root for. That's what makes it entertaining.
Everybody's a critic. You'd be wasting your time. And anyway, it's more fair if there's no bias. It's more fun for the audience to create their own ideas of the characters. That's where discussion comes from.
So you don't want to change anything then? Fine. Let's just talk about how Sebastian...
Sebastian?
Yes, Sebastian. Sounds quite valiant, which is what I think we should go for with this character.
Valiance is such a cheap shot.
Oh my god!
It just takes away the emotion. Like he's not allowed to feel anything because that's weak. It's very unrealistic.
So? It's a film. Who cares if it's unrealistic? Also, isn't that part of his character arc? That he starts to feel sentimental?
Okay. Well, I didn't need you to tell me how to write a character study. Your last film was about a toy rabbit with a machine gun. Classic commercialism.
Well, if you wanted a character that could handle valiance and emotion, then why didn't you write her as a woman?
We're not force-feeding a social agenda. It's a film. It doesn't have to be realistic.
Didn't know you read books.
I just finished reading this book, actually. It was a romance between a lord and a naive boy. The boy is very innocent, so the lord is trying to teach him the ways of the world. But he's very arrogant, speaks mostly and annoying epigraphs, which are always so pessimistic. He thinks art can just explain everything. It's funny how art works. You can't tell someone they're wrong, because it's so personal. But you can't tell someone they're right if you disagree with them.
Can we not all be right?
No. We're too proud. Oh, there's my lunch.
I think we should just scrap this whole scene.
Why?
Because it just isn't working. There's no feeling. Sebastian isn't that type of protagonist. We need to be more considerate of his emotional state in that.
It's okay. It's just a transition scene. There'll be other opportunities.
Oh, no, there won't. It's just... at the moment, he's just another mindless brute. Like he's stuck inside his plastic mould and can't get out. Are you not tired of writing the same old characters? Writing for money rather than emotion. Wasting this beautiful medium and the chance for salvation. For money?
Listen, I work tirelessly for my position. Do you have any idea how hard it is when people like you constantly pass off my work just because they believe I do it for the money? Men like you constantly telling me to try harder while doing nothing themselves.
How dare you be so insensitive? My work is always...
Didn't get much sleep last night. And don't forget to call the script supervisor.